Hello guys, and welcome to this 10,000 subscriber Christmas Q&A thingy. As you might remember, a while ago now, probably like a month and a half, I made a video saying that, well, asking you to put in your questions for a future Q&A, and a month and a half later, we're finally here, and I'm going to answer some of the questions that you put on that video. Won't have time to answer all of them, but I'll try to answer quite a few, but first to get a bit into the Christmas mood, let's get the Santa hat on, shall we? There we go. Just to show that it's Christmas and we're enjoying not being at school or work or whatever it is we tend to do normally. Right, so I've got 5 pages of questions right here, and I'm going to start off with some F1 related ones. So first off, from Jordan Groves, who do I think deserved the championship? Hamilton, Rosberg, and who was your driver of the year? Well, in terms of who deserved the championship, I think that's a pretty easy question, isn't it? Obviously, my man, Kevin Magnussen, is the man who deserved the championship. No, but seriously, obviously, Lewis Hamilton, driving the fastest car, of course, but it doesn't take away the fact that he had some really impressive performances last year and deserved it over Rosberg overall, especially after all the reliability issues that he had. So to bounce back from them was pretty impressive, I have to say. So well done, Lewis! And as for who was my driver of the year, I think that's probably the name that most people would answer for this question, and it is, of course, Daniel Ricciardo, the man who outperformed the 4-time world champion Vettel in his first year as a Red Bull driver, and also being the only non-Mercedes driver to actually win a race, and he won 3 of them, and coupled with the many amazing overtakes that he did throughout the season, I think Daniel Ricciardo was definitely the most impressive driver of the year. Let me know in the comments who your driver of the year was. Next question from Jono Wood says, who is your favorite driver that has at some point driven for Marussia or Caterham? Pretty difficult question. They've had some decent drivers, they've had some quite bad ones as well, but I think I'm gonna go for Heikki Kovalainen driving for Caterham. To me, he was a little underrated as a driver and always a cool guy, so why not? Next question comes from Sid Kumar. We have had Caterham and Marussia leave F1. What are your thoughts about this, and who do you think the FIA should make any changes to the economics of F1? Yeah, I'm quite sad that Marussia and Caterham are gone now, to be honest. I mean, it remains to be seen if they'll be able to scrape something together for next season, but at the moment I think it's looking quite unlikely, isn't it? So yeah, it's a shame because, you know, as far as I'm concerned, the more cars on the grid, the better. And the more teams on the grid, the better. So, yeah, it's a shame. As for changes to the economics, I haven't really put that much thought into it, although it seems clear that there is a problem with costs, obviously. As in most sports, the teams that spend the most money will, you know, most of the time be at the top. But I think the difference between the small and the big teams are probably coming a bit too big, and they should probably introduce some kind of cost cap to limit the big spenders from spending that much more than the small guys. Right, so Jebel Pictures asks, do you think there will be a new team in 2015, like HRT, Virgin and Caterham? I don't think that is looking very likely. I mean, there's talk of Marussia renaming themselves to Manor Racing or something like that, and continuing on in F1. But with Marussia having just sold their factory and everything, I don't think that's really going to happen anymore. So no, I don't think there will be a new team next year. And that leads me on to the next question from Mark Murphy, who asks, what do you think about Haas Racing coming to the sport in 2016, and who will be their main rivals? Well, I think that's great, really. As I said, the more cars on the grid, the merrier, and a new team can't hurt. As far as I'm aware, Haas has quite a bit of money and has run successful teams in NASCAR, so it should be interesting. But I think they'll be down there with the slower teams to begin with, at least. And probably, you know, trying their best to catch up to teams like Sauber and Toro Rosso, which, you know, Marussia and Caterham have tried to for ages without succeeding, but I'm hoping that Haas will have a bit of a better time of it, and hopefully they can be a bit more competitive as well. Aussie Pudge asks, how impressed are you at Kevin Magnussen, Daniel Ricciardo, and Valtteri Bottas this year? Well, I've already touched upon Daniel Ricciardo, my driver of the year, and incredibly impressive, so I won't go into further detail about him, but Valtteri Bottas, another success story, I would say, of 2014. I think he finished 4th in the Drivers' Championship in the end, for a resurrected Williams team, and he also outperformed his much more experienced teammate in Felipe Massa, and was on the podium for God knows how many times. I swear, it felt like every time there was a Mercedes 1-2, Bottas was there as the third place driver in the race. So yeah, incredibly impressed with Bottas as well in only his second year in F1. As for my man Kevin Magnussen, it could have gone better, but as a rookie, I was incredibly impressed, of course, in his first race, coming in as a rookie in his first F1 race, taking second place in Australia. Obviously, Australia was a bit of a weird race, all kind of weird stuff happened, lots of cars breaking down, stuff like that, but to take second in his first race is impressive nonetheless. Obviously, it went a bit downhill from there. He had some impressive drives. I thought the way he fought with the likes of Alonso and stuff in Spa and Monza and some other races, even though he was penalised for some of it, I think he had a pretty decent season for a rookie. But the way he got outperformed on points, at least, by Jenson Button throughout the season is ultimately what let him down, sadly. And then the next question from Guy Saint-Hilaire or something like that. Where do you think Alonso will go? I'm going to take a wild guess and say McLaren Honda. But obviously that question was asked before he actually went officially to McLaren, but I think it was obvious for a few months that he was going there anyway. Right, so Master Snake EU asks, Fizzy, how and what do you think and feel about Jenson Button and Kevin Magnussen's situation? Obviously Jenson will be leaving. Yeah, obviously another question that was asked before the McLaren lineup was announced, and my thoughts on it, they obviously went with Jenson and Alonso. I think that's probably the best possible driver lineup that they could have gone with. I am a Magnussen fan, but I realise that right now Jenson Button is a stronger driver than him. I'm a bit sad about it, of course, because I would have liked as a Magnussen fan to see him in F1 and get, establish himself and gain more experience so that he would faster become better. And it's always that story of when you're out, then it's extremely hard to get back in. But I'm still keeping my fingers crossed that Magnussen will be back in a year or two. But as for next season, for McLaren, Alonso and Button is an incredibly strong lineup. John Bowling asks, what was your favourite F1 race this season? And I think most people would say that it's between Canada and Hungary. And I'm probably going to go for Canada. Obviously, it turned into an incredibly exciting race once the Mercedes cars broke down, with Hamilton retiring, Rosberg falling back into the pack, and then there was some incredibly close battling, some lots of action, cars close throughout the field, and Ricciardo taking his first win in F1, which obviously topped it off. So, that was for me probably the first edge of the seat race in 2014. Right, so Jordan and Peter Beamster are both wondering who I think will win the 2015 Drivers' Championship. Honestly, I think next season will be relatively similar to this. I think Mercedes will still have a dominating car. And out of Hamilton and Rosberg, Rosberg will probably be keen on some revenge next year, but I think Hamilton is overall the better driver, and with less reliability issues as well, probably I assume he'll pull it off again. The Bury Boy 618 asks, what are your thoughts on Felipe Massa? He's my favourite driver, and I've always thought that he had a potential to be amazing. All I really have to say is that he caused the accident with Magnussen in Germany. It was his fault! Dodge Charger 1970, on a one-lap sprint in the same car, who do you think would be the fastest, Lewis Hamilton or Fernando Alonso? Very interesting question, actually, and for me it probably depends on whether that sprint race involves a standing start and the ability to battle. For me, Lewis Hamilton, probably slightly better pace over a lap kind of driver, but in a one lap sprint with a standing start, I think that Alonso would get a better start off the line, because he always tends to get amazing starts. And I think that he would have no problems defending from Hamilton over the course of one lap. So, I'm gonna go with Alonso on that one. Next up, we got Yo-Yo GU2, asking, do you follow V8 supercars? No, sadly, I don't really do that. And secondly, if you were a Formula 1 driver, what team would you drive for? And if you had a choice, who would your teammate be? If I was in F1, I'd want to win. I think most drivers would say the same thing. So if you could pick your team, I'd go with the fastest car, So at the moment, I'd go with Mercedes, because it would give me the biggest chance of winning the championship and races. As for teammate, that's a tricky one, to be honest. I'd go with someone who is experienced, and was a great team player, and I think Jensen Button fits that description perfectly. So, Jensen, you're my teammate.
Well done. So Mr. Brilliant asks two questions. Firstly, favourite race in AOR F1?
Ah, difficult. Many races to choose from there. Many great battles I've had over the years in the league racing. And for me personally as a driver, I'd probably go with Bahrain Season 8 because of the way that I kind of outperformed my ability, I'd say, to be up there and fighting for the win with Limitless and Matty. Is not something I get to do every day, so you know, I still haven't gotten a win in AOR F1, but that was the closest I've gotten with the second place, so yeah, Bahrain Season 8. And then you also asked favourite race in F1 history. You know, it's only been since 2009 that I watched every race live, and during that period, Canada 2011 springs to mind, and I'll probably go with that one. That was, you know, a 4-hour extravaganza. So Rexy Fun asks what age you had the first contact with car games. So I'd probably say I was about 9 years old when I first played like Mario Kart or something. And F1 Petrolhead says, congrats on 10k subs.
Thank you!
And for the Q&A, how long have you been following F1 and what was your first F1 game? Like I mentioned, you know, I've only been a proper fanatic fan watching every race live since 2009, which sadly was the last season that Fisichella was in, so I only got to watch, you know, one proper full season with him. But you know, I've always followed F1 in a less in-depth way since, you know, since I got my first F1 game, which was probably when I was about 10 years old. So in about, yeah, 2001 maybe? And that kind of leads me on to the next question from Kellyan Dian. He's saying that he's Italian, so he knows Fisichella very well. That's good. But he'd like to know how he has become my idol. And it comes back to that, the first F1 game I played, which you know, I was about 9-10 years old, playing on the Nintendo 64 F1 World Grand Prix, I think it was called, based on the 1997 season, when Fisichella was driving this lovely yellow Jordan car. And so when I went on that game to play, you know, I picked the Jordan, because that car is beautiful, and Fisichella had a cool name, so I picked him as a driver, and ended up playing mostly with him. And then when I, you know, saw a proper F1 race for the first season, Fisichella was the, you know, the most familiar name for me, and I just started following him. So that's the story, really. And now everyone knows me as Fizzy. Right. So Jakub Pudorowski asks, what inspired you to make F1 videos? Do you really like racing games? No, I absolutely hate racing games. That's why I play them so much. Pateno UK Submate asks, how long do you spend editing AOR highlights in total, and do you take as much pride in editing into your other videos? You know, on an average, a full AOR highlights package probably takes me about between 10 to 15 hours to edit, and then even more time when you add in the rendering times, uploading times, and I have to do that twice as well, because first I have to upload the uncommentated version for the commentators to watch, and then, you know, the full version with the commentary as well. So, you know, it probably goes up to 20 hours in the end with how long it takes, and that's why it's so hard for me when I'm busy to get them out. But yeah, I always take pride in editing my videos because I try to make them as good as I can, but you know, they are probably the ones I'm most proud of making. The AK Flash asks, hey Fizzy, I love your videos, especially your cut with Kerry. Oh, that's nice, isn't it? Thank you for those great videos, thank you for watching. And your question is, why do you play F1? What is your fascination behind this game? Play it because I like F1, I guess. And I like racing games, and I like competitive racing. So, I guess that explains it. Peter Stockwin asks, what was your reason or motivation to start AOR? Well, you know, obviously AOR is the continuation of the old site, which was called ARL, which I didn't start myself, but I was part of running it from a very, very early time in 2010. But obviously, we had some great leagues there and a great community, so when ARL unexpectedly shut down at the start of this year, you know, I felt like I had this responsibility for the community, and you know, the community was too good to lose, and leagues as well, and that's why I just had to, you know, get something set up, and AOR was the continuation, and the leagues are still going to this day, and hopefully for many years to come. Champ Motorsport asks, what's your favourite track to drive in F1 2014?
Monaco.
NASCAR F1 Boy 42 asks, how did you become a clean driver?
By not crashing into people.
BHO Illusion asks, I would like to become part of an AR Xbox League. Can you please explain briefly how to do this? Well, you go to apexonlineracing.com, you register an account on the site, and then you go on the forum, you find the sign-up thread for the Xbox F1 Leagues.
You read the instructions, you perform the instructions, and then you're set.
Adam Clark is asking if I'm going to do more iRacing races with Kerry, and yeah, that's the plan. Really enjoying iRacing at the moment, so there will be surely some more videos on that in the future. Cathal Prulks asks, who is the fastest person you have ever raced against? And it's probably no surprise, but Noble2909, definitely the fastest I've raced against on F1 and probably any game, so I'm going to go with our 5-time AR F1 champion. Daniel Hadaya asks, why and how did you start making YouTube videos? I guess I just record footage and edit them on the computer. But as for why, I probably just to show off my league races. I bought my capture card for the start of the first, the league season on F1 2010, back on ARL, because I want to record my races and show them off to people. For me, that just adds an extra dimension to the races that I'm able to show other people how my races went as well. Aaron Davidson asks, PS4 or Xbox One?
There you go, Xbox One.
Twizzy F1 asks, so will you ever get in with Matty G's sister? Lewis McDonald asks, do you follow football, and if so, who do you support?
You.
And then Super Elite Gamer 123 asks, what was your reaction when Gerard slipped? And Daniel Hadaya also asks, which team will win the Champions League 2014-15? And obviously, it's going to be Liverpool! What do you mean they're out already? Oh, okay, in that case, I'm going to go with Real Madrid. WRL Hamilton asks, would you like to visit England one day? And I've been there 4 times already, so I'm fucking tired of it now. But no, seriously, I love England, and I was there 2 times this summer. To go karting. Yeah, I met with Neil Lukens, and also Kerry, who every video I make these days, and also the British Grand Prix as well. And the plan is to go next year as well. Green Day Xenophan asks, if you were to move to the UK, where in the country would you want to live? Well, there's one big criteria. It needs to be close to a go-kart track, but I think you guys have go-kart tracks everywhere, so it wouldn't be a problem. But yeah, other than that, I'd probably say somewhere close to Anfield, so I can go to watch Liverpool skip football games, but or London, because, always like big cities. Nilis Lukens asks, can you model the swimsuit you're wearing when you come over for karting next year? You'd like to see that, wouldn't you, Neil? And, oh yeah, the karting video. Oops. Right, almost done. Last page. Spau Physics asks, Fizzy, how is a building if it's already been built? Mikey D asks, how do you pronounce your real name? Well, Knut Martinsen. Or as you English people would say it, Not Martinsen. Elysium asks, thanks to you I discovered Stratovarius with the ARL Veteran Season Review. What a video. But anyway, here is my question. What is your favourite song of Stratovarius? I'm probably going to have to go with the all-time classic, Black Diamond. Whew. Brian Chavoya asks, have you considered to do some more vlogs on your channel? Does this count? Philip Olitz asks, can you make a room tour? Let's do this.
Happy.
And finally, EpicGamer452, when will you do a face reveal or a face cam? So yeah, thank you all for watching this 10k or 12k subscriber Christmas Q&A. I'm sorry I couldn't answer
all of your questions. There was just so many, but thanks to everyone who asked something. And for those of you who still have something to ask me, then you can check out my brand new ask.fm page, which I've just set up. The link to that will be in the description below. You can ask me anything you want there, and I'll answer it if I if I find it interesting, I guess. And make sure you follow me on Twitter as well, and subscribe to the channel if you haven't already for loads more racing videos going forward. Hope you enjoy the video, and I'll see you again soon. Bye. Do you think there will be now be